Stop mauling your cable man and put away those pitchforks and torches, because Blood Bowl is live here on Furlouche's Depot.
All right, let's try this again. Hello and welcome, everybody. It's your good friend Furlouche, also known as Don in Meatspace, and we are back for some Blood Bowl. We are very, very, very off our time schedule here. I was not feeling well earlier, so we didn't get a chance to do the stream on time. But we are getting things done now. Just waiting for it to come up here. And so we are going to be having the... There we go. Ah, that would explain why I was getting horrible echo. We're going to go ahead and introduce our two contestants. Actually, I have the schedule right here. So you will see we are having today the Norse Vikes versus the Engine of WAAAGH. And we're going to go ahead and introduce them right now. Hi, guys. Say hello.
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 So, just to introduce for everybody, go ahead and let's start with Mike Brindle, Norse Vikes. Say hello.
Hello, I am Viking Mike. I love the Norse. I play them all the time, tabletop and now here on the Blood Bowl online.
Thank you.
Blood Bowl for many, many years.
And now his opponent, Mike Joyce. Go ahead and say hello. See. Engine of WAAAGH,
playing the Orcs. Normally don't play Orcs. I've always thought they were, on paper, one of the better teams, so I wanted to see if my analysis was correct.
How have you felt so far?
Yeah, I felt like they've been playing as good as I've been expecting them to.
Okay. Yeah, I really like the Orc team. I agree with you. I think on paper they are one of the better teams.
Yeah, and on the tabletop, they're definitely a solid team. Got that combination of high armor and good skills.
They're not too hard to figure out.
And they have durability to let somebody learn what they're doing.
Not as much fun as playing vampires, but it's a nice little distraction not to have to be so thoughtful all the time.
Right. Plus, you've actually got some ball skills with the orcs as well, which is surprising. You've got some bash... and you can actually occasionally pick up the ball.
Yeah, they really only thing that the team's lacking is speed.
Mm-hmm. Norse is another team I like as well. I played that. I never got a chance to play orcs in our league here because somebody was always taking orcs whenever I went to play it. But yeah, I had a lot of fun with the Norse team. It's whenever I played them, it was basically you knew by the half if you were going to win. Either the other team was in the casualty box or my team was about to be in the casualty box.
Well, I know that Mike's Norse, you're playing without a lot of your positionals.
I deliberately play without the positionals.
Really? You want to tell us a little bit about that?
Well, it's a little trick I picked up from playing on the tournament scene where, you know, you have to pay for all your positionals and that takes money out of paying for other fun bits that your team could have. You pay a premium for a positional or you can just play a lineman and an extra reroll and go on from there. And, you know,
he's taking his power, though. He's got his Yeti and his werewolves, but other than that,
I got the big beasts and the linemen.
I just can't imagine going without the berserkers.
The berserker role is kind of taken with the Norse werewolves.
Yeah, I guess they are sort of similar, but the thing is, you only get two of each of them, so you can't have four.
Yeah, having played Norse for a long, long time, I kind of miss having my third and fourth berserker. Although having the extra strength on the two bear on the two werewolves helped.
See, I got lucky when I was playing. We had I managed to get berserkers with strength and piling on to go with that jump up and mighty blow. It's just brutal, just brutal.
Yeah, that can be a real devastator, piling on all the time and watching people's hearts crack.
Well, anyway, I'm going to not keep you guys busy any longer here, so go ahead and launch the match, and I will tune in as soon as it shows me the match. And good luck to both of you.
Thank you.
Woohoo, accepted and way retrieving.
Also, just so you know, you are going to be facing off against Morath's minions, whoever wins this.
Yeah, I noticed that on the sign-in page that they'd already played their game and the minions won.
Yep.
It was a high scorer.
What is it? You could see the match. It was an interesting match. Like everything that went wrong,
So Mike's taking his inducements, and yeah, that's the expected.
Yep. Yeah. Anytime I get 300,000, I always take the halfling. Because you know, it's not just gaining rerolls; it's taking them away from you.
It is very devastating.
I have five, so even if you take all three, honestly, with orcs two, I can live on fine.
Yeah, I try to reduce my risky maneuvers so that I don't need a buttload of rerolls. At most, I only ever take four.
Well, that's the thing with another thing with the orc team is that when you're playing a bash team, especially a running bash team, it's you make so few die rolls. You're so reliable.
Yep.
I think that's why people like them.
Your main game plan is smashing people in the face.
Yeah. When I have, if I get to use all five, if like they aren't taken away by a master chef, my extra rerolls will sometimes be used for like. I didn't get the down and I'm throwing like a two die block. I might as well just roll again.
Or
pick up ball.
It's oh my gosh, he's gonna possibly score with this. Here, let me throw this ball way to fudge over there and get it out of my zone.
Time to do something stupid.
Actually, I don't know. Like with a lot of bashing teams, I find I end up wasting my my rerolls for a lot of the or at least when playing undead, because you don't have the skills, so you know they can't pick up the ball. They can't really.
So the Norse team sort of has an advantage on that because we all have a block skill. So we only fail punching people 1 in 6 times. You're gonna see me throwing a large number of one die blocks because.
All right, so I do have the match and it is loading. We don't have technical problems like last time.
We will receive.
Yeah, that's not unexpected.
One of the problems with having a very sensitive microphone is it is picking me up trying to open up a wrapper here. Ah, yes, our good friends at Cablevision. So, who's setting up right now?
Mike is.
I am. Yeah, I'm just finishing up Mike.
The orcs are getting squared away.
Don't say Mike is getting set up. You're both named Mike.
That's going to be the running joke for the game.
I've already Mike done it like three times before the broadcast. Okay.
Get to simplify things, we'll call me Mike 1 and we'll call him Mike A.
I hate you so much.
Oh, you can be Mike J and I'll be Mike B. Or you can just call me Viking Mike, like everybody else does.
I am interested in seeing how this works. Because, like I said, you have a very Norse, different Norse team than I would normally pick. So there we got the
combination of years of experience and hours of practice on the on this platform. Everybody plays the game a little different. All right, I think I'm script.
Well, I mean, have you ever seen Wickles Norse?
I'll say no because it doesn't hit my mind.
Well, he was in here before he had to drop out, but yeah, he thinks they're humans.
Oh, yeah, I think we did. Oh yeah, yeah. I think he was my first match for the season, and then he dropped out. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm we have religious differences about his Norse playing, and there's the kick.
And now we lose some time to a riot.
Yeah, and there's the riot. Yep. Wow, both games have started out with the ball being kicked into the end zone.
Yeah, it went deep with my kick skill there.
Yeah, fortunately it's something I'm used to, and my kicker does the same darn thing.
Now, one problem with this match is it's going to be hard to see the chat scroll. Because
yeah, I really
the field
dislike
is white.
This pitch for that. I feel like they should have changed the text color for this pitcher. Ooh, that's not gonna be good.
Yep, that's gonna be a bad start for me. This is gonna be one of them games where it's gonna be pain and pain.
And there is the first turnover for the match.
Of course, I start off with the really stupid, so there's that.
Yep, surprise butt sex all over the place. You know, when you start, it's like, okay, ball's deep, I've got safety, I can go ahead and run and grab it and start things, and no, heavens no, I can't pick the ball up. I've had that happen. I've gone an entire half where I couldn't pick the darn ball up.
I'd point out, if you had your positionals, you probably could pick up the ball.
No, except that Norse throwers don't come with sure hands.
It's true.
Yeah, it's not a default for them. They don't. Their runners are more blitzers, because they come with
with a Dauntless.
Dauntless, yeah.
I usually give one sure hands, though. That's like one of their first pickups.
Well, yeah, but then, you know, there's time that and I like to use my throwers for throwing, so I tend to give them accurate, long bomb, and forget the sure hands bit. Rely on my rerolls for that part. But of course, that time it failed me.
Nothing wrong with using your rerolls for that.
Yeah, especially when the Master Chef gave me two freebies. Yay, block stands up to block. Haha.
Alright, so we are getting towards the end of Engine of WAAAGH's first turn here. Of course, the clocks have been moved back due to the riot earlier, so got a little bit less time. Oh, nice dodge there. and you have to put some pressure on them, but you don't want to commit too much because, in all likelihood, Giftadis is going to get the ball and start moving with it. Really, the best thing is you want to probably tie up all these lone players out here, because these are the guys who are going to form his defensive push forward. Okay, and it is now the Norse Vikes turn.
Have to do something about that instead of just trying to pick the ball up like a boob.
Yeah, that I gotta have that guy in case your die go bad again. Then I've got the threat.
So I hope you don't mind if I go ahead and just blitz him the frick away.
That's fine.
Fender down.
It's all about making your opponent make them die rolls.
That's the other half of life. Every die roll your opponent has to make is a chance he has to fail.
Yep. Triple skulls happen.
Oh, I see you both
Sixes
bought.
And so do ones.
I see you both bought cheerleaders.
I have two cheerleaders, two coaches.
Yep, I find cheerleaders and assistant coaches are very helpful to in the on the kickoff table.
Unless I have an excess of money, I usually only buy under whatever my team's team reroll value is. So since the orcs is 50k, I get 20-20.
Yeah, I gotta say, Viking Mike, it's gonna be hard to get that Yeti to stand up with Wild Animal.
It's part of the reason I also...
It happens.
It's also part of the reason I put a guy back so that he had to blitz. He couldn't use his blitz to get his Yeti back up.
Ah, I was holding the wrong button. Yeah. Yeah.
How does moving him back... Oh, I got you. You mean the guy farther up?
Yeah, because he put the deep threat in, I had to deal with it instead of letting the blitz go to the Yeti to stand up and get up on the line again.
Got it. Smart move.
Yeah, Mike's no slouch. We played before. Skull the Grunt. Ah, well.
And there we go.
And then the idiot picks the ball up. What a star. Okay, I guess that's about all I can do this time.
So looks like we got basically a loose screen going on here. So for those who are just tuning in, we are getting into the beginning of the semifinal match here. Ooh, some action. Werewolf hits the deck. What do those werewolves have for strength? I think they still... Yep, they do have 4 strength. Oh! Well, that's, And that front, that line of scrimmage is just getting annihilated there. So unfortunately, I mean, the Norse all have block, so, you know, they are very difficult to, you know, they're very good on attacking, but when it comes to defending, unless they've got dodge, they're a little easier to get down. Oh. And there we go, one of the Black Rock Orcs. Running some interference, and still have not seen the Blitz yet. I imagine we're going to see that now. Really thought we were going to see a Blitz here. Taking alignment down to the map, and there's the Blitz. Oh, I was not expecting this.
Dodge fail.
Yeah, it was worth the risk.
Well, I mean, you did get the first dodge roll, so... Defender stumbles
and
should take him to the ground.
I freed up those other two guys to come and blitz your guy away from me. Bulk carrier, go, go.
And looks like we should see Drift Datus moving here soon. Oh. Oh, wow. Some very loose formation going on here. This guy can get up.
And the big guy stood up. Yay.
And the Yeti can get up. Huh. I thought he would have moved him back to the ball. Interesting. Okay, and both down over here. And the defender stumbles. And that's... Turn has gone back to the engine of WAAAGH. I don't know, this just seems a very open formation here. Let's see how this plays out. See who's gonna move first. Okay, getting up. Just a basic stand up there. Okay. Pushing up, so now he is adjacent to the ball carrier. That is going to eliminate any assist bonuses that they could give each other. So, really all he has to do now
is... You are kidding me.
Satch trombone.
Oh.
Double one.
Nuffle loves me, this I know, because the dice rolls tell me so. I roll high and you roll low.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, it looks like, yep.
Yeah, that's supposed to be the easy part of that.
3+.
Ah, Mike, you can never guarantee collect underpants.
I tell you, sometimes it feels like agility 4 fails more often than agility 3.
That's because with agility 4 you try more risky things.
Making one dodge into an open zone is not risky.
Yeah, especially when you succeed on anything 2 and above.
Yeah, you'd like to think that, wouldn't you?
I think that's why people dislike a lot of the agility teams is, you know, no matter how good your agility is, you fail 1 out of every 6 times.
Yep, and having achieved the first goal, moved the ball up, I can now spend some time beating people's faces.
Now he says that, but this guy, 3, 4, 5.
Yeah, I was supposed
6.
To be doing that after I
nope.
either failed to put you down or
doesn't have enough movement speed.
Got the ball back.
Well, with going for it, he could make it. I don't know. I'm really not so sure about this. I really think you need somebody keeping these orcs from moving. Okay. Looks like he's trying to get the Blackrock Orc onto the mat.
And block skill wins.
Yeah, it's one of 2 players on the field I have that don't have block.
Oh, you think I didn't notice that?
And standing him back up. Yeah, there it is. Come on, go for it. Not going for it, huh? Ah, saving it for the blitzer. Going for a pushed result. Oh! Yeah, that's gonna be really hard. See? Now we're gonna probably get back into melee over here. Man, this snow pitch just makes it so hard to see anything. Now again, every time these Norse hit the ground, it is pretty easy to break that armor value. A plus will break the armor value on 2 dice.
And now for me to knock away your blitzer and go and score my touchdown.
One, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep, he has enough. He's got enough movement.
And now he will go all the way.
And yes. Yeah, that's all he needs to get the point, so should see him score in a moment. There it is, turn 5. Yep.
Don't get greedy. Remember the goal, score more touchdowns than your opponent does. You get caught up in the bashing, and suddenly you find you've lost the game.
Yeah, the riot may be hurting me a bit here.
Yeah, two turns gone from the first half is a big chunk.
It's really rough on a team that wants to run the 2-1 grind.
Yeah, well, it does impact. Now that you've only got two turns to make your touchdown back, and then there's a whole other half. So, if you score a touchdown
three.
And get a tie, and it comes back to me.
I got three.
Yeah, but it's going to take you four to score.
All right, so we are here on turn six. Let's see how the teams are setting up.
I can score in one, man.
Oh, I didn't notice you had a goblin. Darn.
Always, always have a goblin.
And it looks like I'm going for the deep kick, too.
I'm reminded, like, one of the very first games we had when the league started in 2009. Somebody tried to do the goblin throw, and he ate him.
Yeah, I've seen too many goblins die.
I've actually never had a successful goblin bomb touchdown, but I have, because I play goblins a lot. It's the first time playing orcs, but I do play goblins a fair bit. And I have had goblin tosses work out amazingly defensively, but never as an offensive has it worked.
Yeah, there was one time I was playing a Underdark team, and I had my troll throw a goblin into the middle of the other team's touchdown package. He drifted on top of the ball carrier, knocked him down, messed them all up.
Agent of WAAAGH sitting up now. The Norse have gone for a very loose screen. Honestly, both teams have gone for some pretty loose screens.
The kick is up, and there it goes.
Well, there's his goblin. Oh! Alright, and with a high kick, gets his thrower right beneath it, pretty much exactly where I imagine he wants it to be. So we've got some bashing going on here. Not sure what he's planning here.
Hmm.
Blitz on the side. Not going anywhere. And that player's in a very dangerous position for reprisals next
Worst
turn.
Worst case result there.
Yep, sideline runner ready to get his ass pushed out.
Yeah, because if you just move a player there, that'll force him off the field. Ah. Well, now he's going to have to blitz to force him off the field. Doing. Man, that disturbing presence circle is not nearly as big as I believe it should be. No!
And now take care of the goblin.
Yeah, I'm not sure what the Engine of WAAAGH was planning here. That goblin is just in the middle of nowhere. Nicely done. But be very careful with those werewolves. They don't have block yet, it looks like. Or at least that one doesn't. What are they doing? It looks like the Norse Vikes are just trying to cover as many positions as they can. I guess you have to, because I'm just not really sure. Wow, that is the third wild animal failure so far. I guess you have to cover everything, because you have to wonder what they possibly can get to in the turns they've got. The Engine of WAAAGH does have two turns left. They've got this coming turn and the following one, so there is still a scoring possibility. In fact, here is their turn 7 right now. But they really need to push forward this turn if they're going to have any hope of being in scoring position next turn. Because if they're going to try a 2-1 grind strategy, they really need to score in this first half. Okay. Is that who you're going to throw to? I mean, he does have +1 agility. But he is all alone out there.
That's a great time for that.
Oh, man.
I'm still waiting to catch up and see what wonderfulness happened.
Really stupid. Yeah, very bad time for that. As you can see there, with a plus two for being near a teammate. That was the only roll that would fail on, is a one. Got some more players deep in position now. We're just gonna try to hold off on their running, or the throwing, I should say. Let's see. So yeah, he's definitely trying to stop him. Like, this, I assume, would be Jagrard would be the ideal player to throw to, you would assume. What are they gonna do? And the clock slowly counts down. Only left to wonder
which deep threat should I handle first, or should I just go ahead and run for the ball carrier?
Well, again, the ball thrower has not actually moved yet, so he's got to be thinking, do I throw now, or do I wait until next turn? Because he's, again, he has the deep threat out there, so he's basically forcing the Norse to try to pull back and get any of the players they can. Oh, I expected him to move into some sort of cover.
Well, Mike, moving your ball carrier out of my range definitely means I have to deal with your deep threat.
Indeed. So basically, he's got three deep threat players.
How are you? I just passed the turn. Why do I even waste the time?
Now again, Jagrad is probably the preferred player to pass to. Either of these blitzers could catch the ball, though. Engine of WAAAGH has no rerolls.
Oh, now that was a risky start to that turn. Worked out for you.
Yeah, well, sometimes we get lucky.
I was like, man, I really hope he gets the skull there.
Nope. I saw it. It's like, ooh, thank you, luck. Which pops flat does Mike want to pick? Ha ha ha.
All right. And Orgruff is taken to the snow-covered ground. By Remorse.
All goblins.
Frosty
must
the
die.
Snow Troll. taking down the goblin again. And yep. Now this one does not have block. That might come to haunt him. He's already used his reroll. Will he forget this guy doesn't have block? Oh no, wrong. That's right, that's not a blitz. Silly me! He can only cover, he can't actually push. Push it, covering that player. What you need to do is you need to get... See, if you're going to stop something like this, you need to A, get players on the player who is going to catch the ball, but you also want at least one who is farther out who can attempt to intercept the ball. Because remember, the enemy tackle zones do affect your ability to intercept, and if you intercept it, it never gets to them, period. The rules for interception in Blood Bowl are a little unusual. There it goes. Moving to cover the last player there. This is Engine of WAAAGH's last turn in the half.
Gotta keep it interesting.
Can they score? Now, of course, what would be very interesting is if he moved Jograd into the end zone and then threw to him. I think... Let's see. Oh, God. A movement of five. One... 2, 3, 4, 5. I don't remember what the maximum throw distance is. Oh, there he is, moving. Axel Fan, Fang getting ready to throw. There's an interception failure. And a scatter launch. And that's the end of that.
Some ones again.
I was going to say that was mostly unexpected.
Yep. Looks like...
I had a 75% chance of the ball making into the catcher's hands, and then he had a 50% chance of grabbing it.
You didn't roll ones.
Overall, the odds on that play was about maybe close to 30, 40%, so it wasn't bad, but it just didn't start.
You didn't roll ones. You rolled twos.
Yeah, I rolled twos.
You failed. That's the main point. You tried and you failed.
And there we go, our Norse Vikes cheerleaders.
Not for me to make you do that again.
Now, if I do remember correctly, because this is a cup match, it will not end in a draw. It'll go into sudden death.
Yep, that's my expectation. So if Mike does manage to score, he will kick it to me and I'll have the ball as it rolls into overtime.
Okay.
Yep, sometimes you play for the tie in order to get the win. I'm playing straight out for the win, though. Because why not?
Dead players. Dead players is usually why not.
Well, that's true, but right now I've got my whole team still on the field healthy for the second half. I am pleasantly surprised.
Yeah, I mean, I put you down plenty, but I have no injuries coming. That chef's been good for you today.
Yes, he has. Plus three to me, minus three to you.
By the half in the other semifinal match, the undead had taken two injuries.
Yep, extra rerolls going into a possible potential overtime situation is definitely not a bad thing. And then I get a whole another extra reroll.
Oh, losing three rerolls from the Master Chef.
Reroll as well.
We got a cheering fans event here.
And Don, that's why Mike and I both have assistant coaches and cheerleaders to snatch those freebies up.
I don't know. I've just always been told they weren't worth spending the money on.
I've always found it the opposite. It's usually disappointing when you don't.
All right, and so now the Engine of WAAAGH is beginning their drive. they've had the ball kicked off to them.
It depends on the team, actually.
We have, of course, a massive brawl on the line of scrimmage. And you can see here he is targeting the werewolves, who are the Norse's strongest players, as well as, of course, the Yeti. Ooh, that guard's going to come in handy there.
Some teams, it depends. It's like your reroll cost and how much your team needs rerolls. And... It's never early buy style. For me. Well, some teams also don't end up having a lot of cash on hand.
Yep.
Oh, usually there we go. Sure hands.
Start because you'll find that you want at least that many when you play. I seldom buy more than four.
Morgott has the ball. You know, the other thing, we're seeing a lot of advanced tactics from these players. We're not seeing any of the stereotypical cages that we're used to seeing in a Blood Bowl match. I have yet to see anybody in a 5-pip cage move down the field. It's all been a lot of loose screens and things of that nature. Of course, now it is the Norse Vikes' turn, and they are sitting pretty high with pretty much a reroll every turn they can use. Ooh, two levels of guard, making that very difficult. Oh, there's a skull there. Attacker down. He uses the reroll, turns that into a push. That is the... I imagine he did not want to use the reroll that early. Again, with the werewolves, they have frenzy, so... Gotta be very careful about putting them into situations where things can go poorly for you. See some repositioning of players here. I imagine we're trying to set up some blocks. See, is moving up all his players to intercept the opposing team, leaving one in the back, it looks like. Oh, yeah, it just cannot. So for those who are not familiar with Blood Bowl, Wild Animal is a disadvantage that the Yeti has. All of the big guy characters, as they're known, have a disadvantage. There's Bonehead, Stupid, and Wild Animal. So, I believe Bonehead is just flat out, you fail on if it rolls a 1. 2 plus, you succeed. Whenever these fail, the player does nothing for their turn, and they lose their tackle zones. Wild Animal... you have to succeed on a 4+, so it's a 50% chance. But if you attack or block or blitz or any of that good stuff, you get a +2 bonus, so it becomes, you know, 1 or better, or better than 1, and you succeed. Really Stupid is a similar setup, except you get the bonus if you have a player nearby. You know, the idea is that he's instructing the Really Stupid player. Generally the players with the more disadvantageous penalty, you know, have more going on for them stats wise. So if you play them right, you never really get the 50-50 roll. However, Mike and the Norse Vikes keep getting put into situations.
Mike, you have chosen poorly.
Where he has
only 75% chance is like a 0 for me today.
Yep. Uh-oh. Don't play the odds. Play your gut.
I thought Nuffle liked you.
My gut's are the odds? I'm a statistician.
But Mike, you were singing earlier how Nuffle liked you.
Oh yes, Nuffle loves me because I take the risk and the dice just go my way. See, Mike plays the odds. I play my gut. I think, will Nuffle love me? And I think, yes, and then I just go for it.
Ow! Yeah, he's out of this drive.
In other words, fortune favors the bold.
That did not work out so well. So anyway, Mike and the Norse Vikes keep getting put in situations where he has to do the 50-50 shot on his wild animal because he's down on the ground, so he can't block and he can't get up. And that's all there is to it. Here we go. Pushed again. And we are into turn 10. There we go. Got a 6 to get the Yeti back up. See, there's Mike moving in his reserve player there. Ah, yes. He does have dodge on that blitzer, doesn't he? Taking him out with tackle. Lets him set up another block opportunity.
That's a fair round, bashing
gun. Another defender stumbles. But again, that armor value of 9 makes it very difficult to get an injury on these orcs.
And then I try to be a little fartsy at the end and it flubs.
There's a failed dodge there. No movement there. I see. There's a defender stumbles. Oh, I guess that Yeti's going down, isn't he? Oh! KO on Frosty the Snow Troll! That is going to be a huge development. That just took out a huge chunk of the Norse Vikes' offensive power on the field. Granted, Frosty the Snow Troll has been not as active this match as you would like, but with being KO, there's only a 50-50 shot of him coming back for the next drive, assuming there is a next drive. Yeah, that is crippling. I imagine the Engine of WAAAGH is very happy with those results. All right, let's see. Maneuvering some players. Oh, and it is his plus one agility player. He has gotten him into a threat for a scoring position. Is he gonna throw? There it is! Perfect launch! And the catch! Alright, things just got very interesting. Fortunately, Jargard has already moved this turn. But, the engine of WAAAGH is gonna wanna make sure to protect him, although they've set up a situation. There's just not as many players who can move to intercept him here. 7 sun can make it if he blocks twice.
For the game to turn to go over for Mike, and it's already my turn.
It's part of my strategy. I think you waste time.
Let's see. He's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, he can barely make that with a blitz. So it is possible. Oh, and there it is. There's the blitz. It's going to be 2 going for it. It's worked out so well so far. Oh, push. Not what he wanted. Not what he wanted at all. Were you expecting him to push again for Frenzy?
Who? No. Not that guy. Mostly because he was already maxed out to move to get to that point and throw the one block.
Right.
So I knew that he had to the sideline, so he has to dodge away.
I thought for sure you were going to re-roll it.
No. He's right where I want him.
Hmm.
I actually thought you'd have pushed me back a square because it would have taken me out of the chance to even make the touchdown.
Yeah, you know, Mike, there's 2 ways to roll that, and I decided to go with the odds of forcing you to dodge away or throw somebody in a blitz and having them dodge out of somebody else's tackle zone. Someone's going to throw a die, someone's going to fail, and then turnover.
Like now. Oh, it's a good thing I didn't use that reroll. And imagine we've got a block setting up here from Bjorn the Howler.
The 5Ds of dodgeball.
You can dodge a wrench, you can dodge a ball.
God.
Maybe Patches just used to play Blood Bowl.
And there's the Frenzy kicking in.
Now I kind of want to get a miniature of a guy in a wheelchair and try to mod it up to the Patches and make him my Blood Bowl coach.
Ooh, interesting one die block going on there. Both down versus attacker down.
Then you get to the point where he moves up all your clever, and then suddenly it's like, oh, what am I doing? Oh, wait, no, I don't want to.
And of course, block makes that. That interchange go nowhere, and it is time for the engine of WAAAGH. Let's see how they set this up. Starting with a block. A little surprised about that. What are they trying to do? Moving his Black Rock orcs.
I was half expecting to see that big turkey throw the blitz. Instead, Mike that wasn't worth it with the fails.
He had to take a GFI and didn't want to do that. Again, I my agility 4 is doing nothing for me.
Yeah, you pass up on a 1 in 6 failure for a 50-50 and then you flop it.
Ow!
Well, he made the 50-50. He failed the 1 in 6. He made the first dodge, he didn't make the second.
Oh yeah, now I see that. Yeah, that's true. I did force him to make 2 dodges. Sucker.
He makes the easy one and fails the hard one.
Yeah, I think you should have thrown the blitz there too.
If I fail the blitz, then my if I trip, then the ball carrier is stuck on the sideline where he'll push me out of bounds. If I move up a step, I'll trip and fall, and I had some I had my troll and my guy in the area. There was good odds that where I was dodging two, the ball would land in threat range with them. Then it makes it like he might not make the pickup. I'm in a safer position to recover and make the score up than if I am if he pushes me out of bounds.
Yeah, and then on the other hand, I just run up, pick the ball up, throw a whiff pass, and the guy catches it in the tackle zone. Boom, done.
Yeah, or you know, whatever I set up, everything I set up completely failed.
Oh, I hear some salt.
I told you, Mike, Nuffle loves me.
Yeah, he is this game.
Oh. And clearing some space around the ball carrier. We are now 12-6. And the Norse Vikes have gotten hands on the ball again and are running with
it. It was a great game plan for me to poop on. And then I skull and re-roll skull. Oh well.
Yeah, this is the skulls right here. So he's definitely going to move that thrower in range there. And here we go, Engine of WAAAGH setting up for their next turn here. See where they go with it. Oh, and there's the blitz. Just going straight for the one die. Pushing him away from the end zone there. Still does have one square free. Oh, another KO! Langer being taken down to the mat by Tugsoth. Oh, you know, I can't even pronounce these names. Dat Orc! Call him Dat Orc now. Dat Orc. I want you to know I hate all you guys' team name or player names right now.
Well, I just left them on defaults except for Frosty the Snow Troll.
Right.
Mine look like their defaults, but I actually name every player I always make for teams.
Some of them are hard to pronounce. I've decided their names are now Dat Orc and Dat Boy.
And Dat Viking.
We got Axelfang and Ulkog's Grundlocks.
You mean Dat Orc?
Tugsdorf Grunkta.
Dat Orc?
Draga Mornuf.
The green one?
A lot of my... A lot of my orc names sound a bit like my dwarf names. I have a tendency to that hard consonants.
Well, yeah, don't they both use the same...
I went through Tolkien and found all the orc names and used them.
I really like this guy's name. Togsgarognagfog. I always have a naming scheme for my teams. So, like this one, my black orcs all have double names. There's little, like, consonant cues or the like that I use to differentiate my positions.
Sorry, Mike.
Yeah, and that'll be the score for you.
Cover guy out the way. It's time for me to...
Yeah, there's no real reason to risk not scoring here.
Score. Yep, I'm gonna go all Brazilian now. Score!
Goal! And there it is! And it looks like the Norse Vikes have cinched the win here. I pretty much set up a situation where...
As much as I like watching my cheerleaders swing their mugs, I kind of want to get the game going.
For a team with as much Mighty Blow as I got, I'm not putting you down. I'm not putting you in there much.
Yeah, you're crying about it.
Oh, and the troll is getting up. But unfortunately, the lineman is not getting up.
Still have a chance, but it's going to be...
It looks like
to upgrade the stock
time.
Too risky.
Yep, risky play to not win the game anyhow.
Well, I'll need riots and I'll need riots.
Yeah, you've got two turns to score twice.
You need my internet to collapse right about this second.
Well, I can always score in one turn, so
yeah,
as long
but then
as
you
I have
2-1 losing.
Right, and then I can score on your turn. I can score on your turn in one turn, but it's really difficult. I've done it.
I gotta tell you, if your internet collapsed right now, we would just call it.
Yeah. Well, then it would be up to the commission to say whether I win or not. Not. So I'm gonna stop yammering. Just hit accept my setup and wait for you. Kind of nice having the commissioner sitting on the game just so he can see that I'm actually not throwing these things away just because I'm losing. Because I'm not losing.
Then that proves nothing.
It makes me happy.
Besides, well, you're not on.
You're watching 80s movie videos.
You're not on Wi-Fi anymore, right?
Well, as it happens, yes, I is. Because that's what my girlfriend's house is set up for. And it works, so...
Go to Wally World. Buy an Ethernet cable.
I'm just generally lazy enough not to bother. Well, two more turns. Come on, baby. Hold together. Two more turns.
Interesting setup there. Okay, he is setting up for...
Oh, you needed that extra reroll.
Mostly keeping it out of your hand.
Oh. Right into the thrower's hands. Can he do this?
Yeah, not only wants to keep it out of your hands, too.
Wow.
Apparently, then, I cannot make anything... If it's anything that's like... Only fail on a one, it's not working for me today.
And now I'm going to be that guy. Try to score a third touchdown because why not?
Well, yeah, it's this not a bad play.
Oh, unfortunately, that he was setting up for the goblin throw. Yeah, it didn't work. So
especially
because
my goblin is a move up goblin, so it's even more likely to be able to make the score.
And so, with that drop, the Norse Vikes have just swooped in, grabbed the ball. It looks like they're caging around the ball carrier.
Oh yeah, almost forgot about him. Thanks, Mike.
That's fine. I always play as long as I have a chance at winning, and right now I technically have a chance, but it's so slim. And now it's gone. I couldn't win regardless of the results at this point.
Yep, especially now that your goblin's knocked out.
Well, let me check. So I have a 15. We'll be able to score till 16. No, technically, I could. So I have to play the incredibly infinitesimal odds of success. Basically, I have to... Which means I also had to use the apothecary on the KO.
Oh, jeez. That just puts him back in your reserve box, doesn't it? Doesn't leave him on the
field. No, it lets him stay on the field. It changes the KO to a stun. He'll be out for 50.
I'm so old that I don't even play that version, play that way.
Now that I think about it, if I throw him even with drift, he won't be able to score. So no, it is impossible for me. Never mind.
Yeah, because he's out next turn.
Right, I was thinking that I could stand him up and I could throw him far enough, but the troll needs to be up a few spaces for me to be able to throw him far enough that with his drift roll he would land in the end zone. So, no, it's even impossible by that standard.
Besides, if you move the troll up, then in order for the goblin to get to him, he'd have to move, and that would then validate him to move until the next turn.
Well, no, that's what I'm thinking. I don't think I have an... It's possible. I'll have to see. I'm still going to try it, and we'll see if I can make it work. I mean,
I don't think you can
impossible.
Actually throw him far enough to have him land in the end zone.
Not from here. I need to, on this turn, I need to move the troll up, and then the next turn the goblin needs to hop up and run next to the troll, and then the troll throws him to the end zone, and then or far enough that he can land in the end zone.
That's after one of your guys breaks the ball out of my hands, and then someone else goes and hands it to the goblin.
Right, but I always, even if my chance of winning is 1%, if it's still on the table, I go for the strategy. There's no reason for me not to. I mean, I'm not playing for SPP at this point, so. If I'm playing for anything, it's that 1% chance of success.
Well, I gotta commend them.
And non-blocking werewolf for the loss. But I did move your troll back another space.
Not to mention the troll is going to be affected by the disturbing presence on the Yeti. It's going to make any sort of throw very difficult. But we'll see what happens here.
Yeah, and he's not a dodging troll, unfortunately. I don't usually build him that way, so...
Yep. No.
Well, getting the ball free from you won't be the problem, or shouldn't be.
Yeah, I figured that was going to be the least of the issues. And there's that strip ball blitzer.
Now, picking it up is another matter entirely.
Yep, there is that. Every extra die roll you have to try to make is an extra die roll for you to try to fail.
Oh, let's see. What is he setting up here? Oh.
And non-dodging troll for the loss.
Yep. Womp womp.
And it looks like we're basically just finishing up at this point. I don't think there's really any way that, well, yeah, there really is no way for the Norse Vikes to lose this at this point.
And since I can't win at this point, and I don't need to take revenge because you haven't killed any of my players, I will do the gentlemanly thing and ridiculously try for a pass roll.
Okie doke.
But not be you.
Earn yourself an extra star player point. Go ahead.
Yeah, the way I usually do is I try not to be mean and hurt somebody if there's no benefit for me in it.
Yeah, go ahead. Do what you want to do, buddy. Whatever helps you sleep at night. The thing I mainly care about is that I win the game. Excellent game, Mike.
Yep, good game. Wish I could have come out to play, but apparently my dice wanted to stay home today.
Yep, you gotta make the proper sacrifices to Nuffle, buddy.
And with that, it looks like our game is finishing up here.
Now I'm just gonna go ahead and take a knee and end the game.
And there we go. There is the end of game. And so the Norse Vikes.
Good luck in the finals. You got to win because if you don't win, then it means I lost to the person who didn't win. That's terrible.
Yeah, well, I don't like it when that happens either. And I've beat the minions a couple times already, so it's like, oh, how could I not beat them now? Dang it.
Well, you've only played them twice, so.
Well, okay, one win and one tie. I haven't lost to them yet.
All right, well, that is the end of the match there, guys. Do you have anything else to say before we turn off the broadcast?
No, excellent game. Great playing you, Mike. Having fun this season. Can't wait for the playoff.
Yeah, it's always good to, since you're not in the area, it's good to have another chance to be back on the pitch with you, even if it's... The pitch has to be, half in the good part of Virginia and half out in the part of Virginia.
Up in the mountains, yeah. It's good that we can still get face-to-face-ish, despite the distance between us.
Voice-to-voice-ish.
Yeah, mostly-ish.
Well, you can always set up FaceTime before you play.
Oh, yeah. Well, when I first got onto Blood Bowl, I found Clancy and he... We did a couple games and got me into the flow of it, so I'm ready now for this.
All right, well,
I wish that my only issue with this with the Blood Bowl platform is that I'm always loath to play my favorite team on it. Because it's with the vampires, it's the team that the game is most likely to mess up on. Because it sometimes doesn't interpret pro correctly.
Isn't it supposed to just give you an extra reroll that you can use when they're up and on the field?
Yeah. Well, what happens is if you you can set the options to make it to use pro, but the way they coded it, it doesn't always fall the right way, or it forgets in your option menu. And what you don't want to do is sometimes you want to use your team reroll and not your pro reroll, because your pro reroll is only a 50% chance reroll.
Got it.
But the game will sometimes be like, do you want to use a reroll? And if the player has pro and you click yes, it's like automatically their pro reroll. And it's like, no, I wanted the better odds one.
Is there a difference between the pro reroll odds and a regular reroll odds?
Yeah,
well,
regular
reroll is you roll straight, whereas with the pro reroll, you have to get 50% before you even get the reroll. Come on, Mike, you're the statistician. You should know that.
Yeah, you got to get a 4, 5, 6 before you can even make the reroll.
Gotcha.
And not a lot of teams take pro, but vampires really take pro.
Yeah, I'll usually take pro on like a on an ogre or a a troll or a yeti or a minotaur.
Yeah, it's
something that,
it's
something
big,
that has wild animal.
It's a good big guy skill. It's also a decent on some teams. It's a decent what I want to say like. Maybe like fourth or fifth skill. Slan, I've seen take it a few times. But your average, your humans, your elves, your dwarves, your orcs, they don't really pedal in it too heavily on their regular players.
Yeah, anybody that has to do a four before they can use the normal reroll should take pro on their big guy.
Yeah, that's always the question is if you do block or pro and when you get the doubles on your big guy. And I'm... Depends on the player for me. Depends on the big guy.
And it depends on the team. For example, yeah. For a Norse team, I'll take the block, whereas most other teams, I'll take the pro just to get the... Because the pro lets you reroll any dang thing.
Yeah, on humans, if I take the ogre, which I don't often, I actually don't like to take the ogre on humans, I will pro the ogre a lot because I like to make him a roadblock. Whereas the troll team, I'm mostly counting on my troll to try to get casualties. So I like throwing block on there because it gives me a little more reliability in smashing people in the face.
Yeah, except for when he decides he doesn't want to smash people in the face.
Yeah, but it's a I could count all the times where it's like if I was I would have thrown and only gotten like a push and a both down and I got the hit down. So it's like, yeah, it's half on one hand, half on the other, but my ogre is more likely to be operating independently, which is, or like I'm putting him there for him to be a tackle zone. So I want that pro to really make sure he keeps his tackle zones. Whereas the troll, it's like, he's there to throw. That's why, like, I don't piling on my ogre, but I'll put piling on my troll.
All right,
again,
guys.
I don't
well,
normally play orc, so
I'm going to go ahead.
I do pro my trolls on goblin.
Going to go ahead and turn off our broadcast. Yeah. So
there we go. Got a touch of Bubble philosophy at the end.
Thank you very much for watching.
To the other mics because he's the one who won, so he knows what he's talking about.
Oh yeah. Good night. Yeah. Good fight. Good night.
Later.
All right. I look forward to seeing everybody for the final, where the Norse Vikes are going to go ahead and face off against Morath's minions. Good night, everybody.
Woohoo.
Yep.
This has been a production of Furlouge's Depot and the Blood Bowl Association serving Hampton Roads and cannot be altered or rebroadcast without the express written consent of Furlouge's Depot and the Blood Bowl Association serving Hampton Roads and the all-powerful Sir Mufti Rudy Toot Toot void where prohibited. Consult your doctor if you experience dizziness, trouble breathing, or your left toe transforms into a beast of Nurgle.
Conan, what is best in life?
To see the enemy team before you. To crush the star blades beneath your feet and to hear the lamentation of their fans. That is why I'll be back for the new season of Bash, Hampton Roads Premier League of Blood Bowl. But I need you, your friends, and even your little girly poodle to sign up now. So put that cookie down now and get your ass to Bash. The website is right there at the bottom of your screen. So what are you aiming for? Do it now. I'll see you at the party.